From the dawn of time they came, moving silently down through the centuries, living many secret lives, struggling to reach the time of the gathering when the few who remain would battle to the last. In the end, there can be only one. But right now, there's 24 booster packs, that is, of the Highlander the Card Game Gathering Expansion, to open right here on this channel. Hi, folks. Welcome to the very first Professor Rocket versus Foil Wrappers, I guess. Unwrapping. It's not an unboxing because it didn't come in a box, but anyway. If it's not an unboxing, what should I call it? Post in the comments below and tell me by which time it will be too late, because I will have already titled the video and it will be irrelevant. But at least I'll know for next time. So, yes, Highlander the Card Game. I picked up these booster packs pretty recently. Very recently. Just came in the mail today, in fact. This is a set that's pretty hard to find these days, The Gathering. I've only come across two booster boxes of this set within the last 10 years. It's easy to find starter decks of this. Booster packs are pretty hard, and they have quite a different assortment of cards in them. While they're all theoretically pulling from the same pool, there are certain cards that are virtually impossible to get out of starter decks, and likewise some that only seem to come from starter decks. So, really quick information on Highlander. Highlander was a 1986 movie starring Christopher Lambert and Sean Connery. It was about an immortal named Connor MacLeod, a.k.a. the Highlander, who's a member of a race of immortals who can only die if their heads get cut off. And if they're killed by another immortal, that immortal gathers the knowledge and power of the slain immortal, and they are driven by an urge to battle until only one remains, and he'll supposedly have all the power of all the immortals that ever lived. Now, the coda, well, the sort of through line of the movie was there can be only one. And in the end of the movie, there is in fact only one, that's Connor MacLeod. So there was not really any room for a sequel, but that hasn't stopped them from trying many times over the last 3 decades to varying degrees of success. But we're not here to talk about the movies right now, we're here to talk about the card game. And this is one of my favorite card games from the 90s, and indeed ever. First off, I was a huge Highlander fan. This card game probably best represents Highlander better than any other property that I've seen a card game made of. This plays like it should. This card game plays like a sword fight. There were tons of distribution problems, manufacturing delays during the original run of the card game, but it's got a huge like cult following. There have been several like small press revivals of it, short runs of follow-up, revised editions of it, and just a small group of really determined fans keeping this game alive for about almost 25 years now. This set was from 1996. I'm not gonna waste any more time telling about Highlander or the history of the game, just that it's a great game. It's my favorite game, so let's tear open some packs and see if I can get some of the rare cards that were supposedly semi-exclusive to this set. And let's see. Be a lot of crap. There were, by the way, 6 sets. Full expansions released, and I'm just going to be picking out some of the rare cards as I go. Anything phenomenal, I will point out. And they alternated between, for the most part, they alternated between series edition and movie edition, because there was a spin-off series, which again had to basically take place in its own universe, since the movie was a self-contained storyline. There was originally series edition in 1995, and I believe the first movie edition came out the same year. The following year in 1996 was Watcher Chronicles, which was another series-based expansion. And then this set, The Gathering, which is, for the most part, a reprint of movie edition, but with several new immortals added in. And one of the things that was kind of unusual about this card game was that there were some two-sided cards, while normal in-game cards had just regular backs with the logo on it. Character cards and other quote-unquote pre-game cards would have a full-size picture on the front, and then like a character bio, and then the actual game text on the back. Pre-game cards tend to be really powerful, and you have to have like a particular character in your pre-game to use the cards that go with them. So like if you wanted to use cards for Amon Fazil, you would need to have the Amon Fazil persona card. And each immortal has like their own special game text on the back of their persona power, which basically lets them bend the rules in a way that's unique to that character. So, let's see. Yes, this was the fourth set. There were only two sets after this. And this is a set that came in both starters and boosters. And the two remaining sets after this, there was Arms and Tactics, which introduced Weapons of Choice. And there was Four Horsemen, which introduced a lot of new immortals, but didn't really introduce any new concepts. And it was available in boosters only. Series Edition was available in boosters and starters. So it was Movie Edition, Watcher Chronicles, and Four Horsemen were only available in boosters. So here's a McLan Cloud Bagpipes. These go in just about any Connor McLeod or Duncan McLeod deck that I build. And it works with either one of them. Most locations are pretty good. In fact, most of my decks are built around locations, so it's nice to see any of those. The two big cards that I love to pull from this set are Amon Fazil's Backflip and Kurgan's Master Headshot. They are really powerful cards. Back when I used to have a website selling CCG singles, either one of those cards would sell for like $17 to $25 each. Let's see, here's a Kasigir Master's Guard lower. There's a lower version and an upper version. This one, the lower one, I believe is the rarer one. Again, this is one of those that seems to only appear in the booster packs. It shouldn't. It should be in starter decks too, but I've never pulled one from a starter deck. I always pull them from booster packs. Whereas the upper one, on the other hand, I mostly just pull from starter decks. I think I've pulled some from booster packs, but it's pretty rare. And, just seeing. Yeah, 1996, copyright. Yeah, so I had, making sure I had my timeline lined up. So, I believe all six sets came out from, between 1995 and 1998. I think either 98 or early 99 was the last official release. Now, some really dedicated fans and okay. Here's Amon Fazil's backflip. One of the two rarest cards. Yeah. Just about any Fazil deck will probably want to max these out at four, or even use a Darius to increase the restriction to five, which is what I always do. And let's see, where was I? Okay. So that was the really good card in that pack. What was I talking about? I don't know. Doesn't matter. Oh, so yes, actually, a lot of really dedicated fans, as well as people involved with the creation and play testing of the initial game, have kept it alive. Ooh, this is actually an uncommon, but it's a very useful uncommon. Both of these are actually Focus and Recon. And I believe these are both rare. They've kept it alive for about 2.5 decades now. There were other small print run expansions released. There was a second and very brief third edition of the card game, which revised the rules. Came out with a lot of errata, released characters from the fourth movie and anime. Yes, there was an anime movie. As well as featuring characters from the fourth and fifth movies. The original run of the card game ceased publication just before the fourth movie released. So, nothing from that movie on ever appeared in the card game until the newer editions came out. So the original, this was originally published by Thundercastle Games. There were some special sets created for charity by Saic or Slim Bones Auctions around the year 2000, 2001. Then Thundercastle sort of reformed as a Le Montagnard, I believe, and published second edition. Then apparently had some problems, became known as Paradox Press, I believe, published third edition. Third edition was apparently really expensive to produce, so they went back to producing second edition revised. Don't really know what the point of that was. And when second edition first launched, it was launched in the same format with boosters and starters, and that model got really expensive and old pretty quickly. And wow, a backflip, another backflip. This is like two backflips in less than a box. That's pretty amazing. Yeah. So, lost focus again. Anyway. Yes, it went to sort of a living CCG model, where it was released in what they call versus packs, where you would get two pre-constructed decks with new immortals that came together. Oh, this is a pretty rare card for Fazil also. Fleche? I've never known how to say that, but pretty rare. And they did that for several years, And it looks like the last 2 or 3 years have just sort of dried up. I think they've pretty much made everything they could have made until somebody makes more Highlander movies, and there's nothing, not been any new Highlander media in about 13 years. So they've made pretty much every card they can. They've made a revised version of every card they can. Until something revitalizes the franchise, it looks like the card game's pretty much done. Although, oddly, it still has a really strong secondary market. Like I said, I've only found two booster boxes of this set within the last 10 years. The first one was about 10 years ago. It sold for $60. The last one I found sold for nearly 100. And this right here, this was a lot of 24 packs. This was $40. There are some sets that basically you just cannot find anymore at all. Arms and Tactics is virtually impossible to find. The first print of Movie Edition is virtually impossible to find. But there's a few wholesalers also, wholesalegaming.com or Hills Wholesale, as it's called, and Potomac Distribution still have stockpiles of some of the sets that are still available. Watcher Chronicle seems to be pretty plentiful. Four Horsemen seems pretty plentiful, and there's still plenty of starters of this set also, The Gathering. At pretty affordable prices. But then you get those rarer sets like Movie Edition and Arms and Tactics, and those boxes are going for over $100, which is what they were selling for 25 years ago, which is kind of crazy. When some of them got down to about $10 to $12 a box for a while, and before just vanishing. Again, most locations are good. The stock is a great card for Amon Fazil. Amon Fazil is also one of my favorite characters to play, so I'm kind of setting those all to the side. And I really like the look and packaging of this set. Just like all the blue, very classic. Kind of the blue on blue design. Has had a lot of influence on. This is a pretty rare card. They never got around to making a Ramirez Persona in first edition, but they did make two of his cards, Master's Advantage and Experience Counts, as gold foils, ultra rares in this set. And the ultra rares are supposed to be, the gold foils are supposed to be one or two per box. Their assortment process is total and utter shit. I have gotten as few as none and as many as eight in a single box before. I've even gotten two in the same starter deck, which isn't supposed to happen, but like I said, assortment process is terrible. And ooh, in that same pack, another rare Fazil card. Set that aside. And there are other rares in here, and I will go back and sort these out after the video. So I'm just kind of pulling out some of the highlights. And again, most people's reaction to hearing was shocked to hear that there even was a Highlander card game. Oh, and here is another gold foil. So we've already exceeded the promised one gold foil per box. And I've even run across cases of what they called God boxes. Here's an Amon Fazil Persona card, where There were no uncommons in the packs. There were commons, and then there were rares where they were supposed to be, and then rares where the uncommons were supposed to be. So a third of the deck was rares. So yeah, pretty crazy. Terrible assortment process. And sometimes it was because they would have really small sets, but they would use the standard 15 count booster pack size. And Star Trek, the Star Trek CCG ran into the same problem too, where they had a set that was 120 cards, alternate universe. And the same thing happened with Q Continuum. But they were using 15 card packs. So they were using the same assortment process as they had with their first set, which was 360 cards. And as a result, you would get duplicates and even triplicates within the same booster pack because the set was so small. But you were still getting 15 cards at a time. Highlander cards were pretty well known for having larger image areas than most CCGs, so showing off the images pretty well. It's a pretty easy game to learn too. It's very fast paced. A game can last for hours if you're very unfortunate. But it can also end on the first turn because, just like in the movies, if you lose your head, you die. And if somebody places a lucky headshot on the first turn, they can win the game on the first turn. Doesn't happen very often, but it does happen. And wow, there is my third backflip. This is pretty amazing. Yeah. So it looks like I was meant to build an Amon Fazil deck out of this box. But these cards did vary wildly in quality, not just the assortment process. I once pulled a booster box of this very set where the paper stock was defective. So the actual plies of the paper were peeling apart. The front and back of the card were peeling apart. Usually think of a sheet of paper or cardboard being a solid piece, but a lot of card stocks are actually built up in plies, just like toilet paper. And so those plies were coming apart, and it was only the rare cards that I was pulling from the packs. So all the rare cards in that box just like fell apart like butterfly wings. It was pretty disheartening. And at that point, the company had gone bankrupt, so there was no appealing for to quality control to get replacement cards. Another Amon Fazil stock. This is a real treasure trove for Amon Fazil this time. Nothing else extraordinary. See, Kane's Fury, that one's pretty rare. Fletchmag. Really nothing noteworthy in that pack at all. Ooh, and here is the other exceedingly good slash valuable card, Kurgan's Master Headshot. Great card for one of the most brutal personas in the game. Main villain of the original movie. And okay. Getting pretty low. Three packs left. But even if I get nothing else good, this is a pretty amazing pull so far. And another premium card, this time for the Kurgan also. So yeah, only guaranteed one per box. I already got three of those. And one of the things I really liked about this game, by the way, is you had cards that had generic designs like this. They were just sort of the gray background. But then each character had their own design also for the background of their specific cards. So like Amon Fazil's card has these green backgrounds that are like a, I think it's an extreme close-up of the parking garage where he fought Connor. And the background of Kurgan's cards are like an extreme close-up on the armor he wore when he fought Connor in the Highlands in the first movie. Alright, so two packs left. So, design-wise, Highlander was one of the best CCGs around in the 90s. Also, fun-wise. Distribution-wise, not so much, because it was pretty hard to find without ordering from a distributor. And here is a fourth foil card. So now we are at four times the expected frequency of the premium cards. No complaints there. You've already lost. That's a pretty good card for Nakano. Kane Persona card, Simple Mind. All three of those cards are pretty good. Not mind-shattering, but pretty good. And very last pack. Completely underwhelming, but hey, I got really good stuff out of this pack, out of this lot of packs. So there you go. Half hour ago, you probably didn't even know that there was a Highlander card game. Now you've seen almost a whole booster pack opened, and I made a great big mess, great big mess of booster pack wrappers. And that's what we do here on this channel, is we make great big messes. And then if you want to win this mess, if you want to win this lot of empty Highlander CCG wrappers, just post a comment. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to fool with that. Alright, so, yep. Alright, hey, thanks for watching. There can be only one.